In this video, I want to show you how I compare a track that was just released for my band Awash on the various streaming services. I will show you how to set up the audio in Cubase so that it's easy to compare them, and I will show you a trick that makes it easier to see the difference between the output of the streaming service and the original master. So let's go! So to start off with, I have a project here in which I recorded the output of several streaming services. If you have a look, you can see that the first track contains the master. So that's the master that we made from our mix, which contains the most original audio. The next track is a recording of the Spotify when it was set to the very highest quality, which is only available if you have a Spotify premium subscription. The next track is the Spotify high quality, which is available in the free subscription. Then we also have a video of this track on YouTube, which I recorded the sound of. And the last track is recorded from Deezer with the setting the standard quality, which is available in the free Deezer subscription. Now, how I got all these tracks into Cubase, I will not go into this video, because I already have a separate video about how I do that. It's the part about how I record a reference from Spotify, which I'll link to over here. So as you see here on the screen, all these recordings are not really in sync. And if I zoom in, you can see the original track starts here, and the next track starts at 3 seconds, and 3.5, etc., etc. So the first thing I want to do is I want to sync up all these tracks so that when I switch to compare the various streaming services, I don't hear the switch at all, in that the track doesn't skip or anything like that. I should just hear the switch by hearing a different audio quality. So how do I do that? Well, first of all, I'm going to make sure this one starts at 1 second. I'm going to cut this one to make sure that it starts approximately at the same position. I'm going to zoom in much further. Now over here you see that this bump here in the audio is probably this one. So I'm going to move that to be in sync. I'm going to increase this a little bit so I have a better view. I'm also going to make these tracks a bit higher. And now first thing I'm going to do is probably I'm going to sync up where they have the zero crossing. Over here you see this is pretty much the beginning of zero on this top line here, which is over here in the Spotify high EQ. You see that it's not exactly the same, because over here you see that it comes off of the zero line and over here it goes on a little bit longer, but that's exactly the difference in audio quality that you're going to hear. So, because there is obviously a difference between the master and what I recorded from Spotify. Now I'm going to move a bit towards a different section, maybe where the song kicks off into the more heavy part. Which is somewhere over here. This is also a pretty big peak. And we can see if it's in sync. And this is the rise to the highest part in the master. And you see that this is also the rise to the highest part in Spotify, very high quality. So I think these tracks are pretty much sample accurate now. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that they end in exactly the same spot. I'm going to set the grid to events so that it snaps exactly to the start of the top track. And the end, I want to snap to exactly the same position as well. So there you go. Two tracks in sync now, and I'll do the other ones off camera so you don't have to sit through that whole process. Okay, after having done this for all recordings from the streaming services, the project looks like this. They're all nicely synced, and every event has been made equal length. Because next up is making sure that all of these events play at the same volume so that it's fair to compare. So what I'm going to do for that is I'm going to basically measure all the statistics for all these tracks. This is on the first track. Second track. And again, I'm not going to make you sit through all of this, so. So this is the output of the various recordings. What you need to look at is the integrated loudness, which is an indicator of how loud the track is, and we basically want all tracks to play back at the same loudness. So the master is at minus 10.5 LUFS. The Spotify tracks are actually also at that same loudness, so they're pretty spot on, which is a terrible joke, but okay. YouTube is at minus 14 LUFS, and Deezer is at minus 11 LUFS. So now you can say, well, you can raise Spotify to also measure minus 10.5 LUFS and also raise Deezer. But if I do that, then there may actually be a clipping because I don't know whether the peaks in the file are able to handle that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lower all the tracks to the softest one. I will lower everything so everything plays back at minus 14 LUFS. So our master is at minus 10.5. So I need to lower it by minus 3 dB. Now, there's several ways you can do this. You can also do it with the volume, with the fader on the mixer, but I'm actually going to type in the value here on the event. Volume minus 3.5. Same thing with Spotify, also needs to go back 3.5 dB. Both Spotify tracks. Now YouTube is already at minus 14 LUFS and Deezer needs to go back minus 3 dB. Now we can get rid of these statistics. And do a quick test, soloing between the various tracks to see if they're somewhat at equal loudness. Me when I die, you're the light. You make me see behind the wall. You're the wall. And to me, it's a pretty seamless experience. There's no skipping, and the loudness also doesn't seem to skip. So I think this is a very good version to compare these recordings. Okay, now on to the actual comparison. So we will listen to various parts of the individual tracks, but because you're listening everything at YouTube quality, you may not be able to tell the difference between the tracks. I'm going to try it, see if you can tell the difference, but after the regular listening, I will also do a method in which you will be able to hear and see the difference. So hang in there. You're the one, you heal me when I die. You're the light, you make me see behind the wall. Okay, now the same part every time. You're the light. I still see you have no fear. You're the light. I still see you have no fear. You're the light. Okay, so I'm not sure that you're able to hear it, but to me, the master sounds most crisp. Spotify Very High sounds, yeah, pretty good. It's a bit muffled. YouTube is most muffled to me, more mids, less highs. And Deezer actually sounds a little bit thin and brittle to me. Now, you may not be able to hear those differences. I have to say the differences are not very great here either when I'm listening to speakers in an acoustically treated environment. But still, if you listen very carefully, you can hear the differences. Okay, so now I want to make the comparison a little bit more scientific, so you will also be able to hear the difference and see the difference most of all. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that the master always keeps playing, and I'm going to invert the phase of all the tracks. Now, if the reproduction of the audio was perfect, then what you would hear if I combine the master with any of the other tracks like this, you would hear nothing. To demonstrate that, I will make a quick copy of the master. I will also invert the phase of the master. And you see now, if I play the master phase inverted together with the original master, you're hearing nothing because the audio completely cancels out itself. So if you now listen to, for example, the Spotify Very High, what you're hearing is a difference between the master and the output of Spotify Very High. Now, and I do not just want to listen, but I also want to actually compare these. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure the loudness of the remaining signal, basically. And the lower the loudness of the remaining signal, the better the recording resembles the master recording. With this button, I can reset the measured values every time. So I'm going to do the same part in the track every time. So this is Spotify Very High. Now, if you see the integrated loudness of the different signal is minus 44.2. So I'm going to write that down. Now for the Spotify High quality. Reset the measurement. Integrated loudness is minus 44.2, which is actually very much the same. Now for the YouTube. The integrated loudness of the different signal is minus 23.2. Now for Deezer. Integrated loudness of the difference is minus 30.2. So the Spotify results are very surprising, because it doesn't really matter if I set it to very high quality or high quality. The output file that I record from Spotify is exactly the same. So now the question raises in my mind, am I always getting high quality? Or am I always getting very high quality? And maybe they just don't scale down the quality because I have a premium subscription. At this point, I don't know, so I'll try to investigate. Anyway, The track that I used for this is our latest single release called Shadow or Sun. So if you like it, I would very much appreciate if you listen to it via the streaming link that I will include. And yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Thanks again for watching. I hope you like this video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and ring the little bell icon so you know when I post another video. The video that's shown here on my left and your right is a video that's about the making of the song that you just heard in this video. So, have a look, see if you like it as well. See you soon!